channel. It's Shadia.
It's Raheem.
Yep. So I have a special guest, Raheem. Go check out his channel.
My channel is Raheem Thompson. I also make music videos. I vlog. I do a lot of stuff.
Yeah, he does. It's going to be in the description bar below. So yeah, basically, as you can see from the title of the video, it's going to be a college advice video because I was asked in one of my comments. I'm not sure which video, but someone asked me to do a college advice video. So basically, this is going to be for freshmen coming into college because I'm only a sophomore, so I can't tell you about the other years, you know? But basically, I feel like, number one, stay focused on your work first, for real, because procrastination is...
They'll get you.
Boy, do I procrastinate. And it really hurts me because at A&T, we have so many events that happen. And let's say you have an assignment during Lane 59. And you want to go to this step show that's at 7.
Yeah.
So now you're thinking the whole time, oh my God, hope it gets over. Right. Yeah. Right. So, yeah. What do you think?
So I definitely say, you know, on top of staying on top of your assignments, try to get ahead as much as possible, you know, trying to knock those papers out as soon as, you know, they're given, maybe that weekend that they're given, get it done right away so you don't have to worry about it. A lot of college classes have like online softwares that you have to like buy codes and get like stuff done on there. So just staying on top of those due dates and, you know, just trying to get as ahead as possible. If the homework's always due on a Sunday, try to get it done on like that Wednesday night or something like that. So you have your weekend free and you have nothing to worry about.
Yeah. And to add on to that, I will also say make sure you're studying because freshman year, I told y'all this before, but I didn't study as much as I should. And my grades showed. Yeah, so make sure you study. Like, for each class, take like a couple hours a day to study for each class. So yeah. another tip,
I say I use speech to text sometimes. So if you're writing your essays, you know, pull up your notes app on your phone, just talk to your phone the whole time. And when you're writing papers, don't, you know, think too heavily about what you're typing at first, but just get all of your thoughts down on paper. Like, I'll sit there and talk to my phone for like a good hour. I could be like a good 5 pages right there. Throw it onto my computer and edit, then you have, you know, all the content that you need to write the paper. You just have to edit it on your computer now, so it's a faster, efficient way to write papers.
Okay. I didn't think about that one. What tip number are we on?
3. This will be the 3rd one. So we did 1, 1, 2, 2.
All right, y'all. I don't know. I'll figure it out. But tip number 4, if we're on number 4. What was I about to say? Oh, time management. Time management is key. Because in college, you're always going to have something to do. Like, you might want to go to breakfast. Your friend might ask you to go to breakfast in the morning. Mm-hmm. But you might need to study for this exam you about to have in, like, an hour. So you thinking, like, should I go to breakfast? Like, or should I study?
Yeah.
And then also, later on in the day, like I said, get your homework done. Because later on that night, you can be like, oh, I forgot. Right. There was an event I wanted to go to. Now it's like, do this homework real quick. Mm-hmm. Or go to the event and then try to do it afterwards. Like, you just gotta figure it out. Like, manage your time wisely. I promise you.
So I definitely say multitask is, you know, a good way to succeed. When I have like a lot of projects going on, I gotta edit a video or something like that, I like take it with me to the CAF. So a lot of times I'll be in the CAF with my friends. You know, there's a lot of dead time where they're just sitting around, just like, oh, that food's so good. I'll be on my computer editing, and it's like really efficient. I could walk out the CAF with an entire project done. Yeah, so multitasking.
Done. What's another? I would say eat healthy, but the CAF is what we really have.
Yeah.
But I do think eating healthy is really important because I need to eat healthier because I would it would definitely help you in classes, like, with your brain smart. Because they always say eat breakfast, and I feel like that's important. And that's also key, tying to time management. So if you have the time to go to breakfast, go to breakfast. Mm-hmm. I think going to breakfast is key. Make sure you get a good meal at night. I don't a lot of times, but that's good advice. So, yeah.
I'd say, you know, just to piggyback off of your health, going to the gym,
I just started.
Yeah, you gotta go to the gym at least, you know, twice a week. Something to get you, you know, physically on point. Because, you know, sometimes you walk to class and, you know, you'll be tired. But, you know, you want to have some type of activity in your life to stay healthy.
And you don't want to gain that freshman 15.
Oh, no, you don't want to do that.
I didn't gain it, but I wish I did. But yeah. I didn't. But some people aren't lucky as me, maybe. And they don't have a high metabolism like me. So if you're like the other half of me who don't, who does gain weight, then go to the gym. Yeah. I know some people who definitely got the freshman 15.
Oh, damn. Nah, yeah. My freshman year, I was like, I think I was like 10 pounds lighter than I am now, and then like my sophomore year I was like 20 pounds lighter than I am now.
Wow, you're losing weight.
Yeah, and then right now, like, this is the biggest I've ever been.
Oh yeah. So okay,
but
I see what you're saying.
Just, you know, being healthy
is important.
Multitasking,
it's very important. It ties all into your mental health of, like, trying to live your life as a person. Second, as your education, you want to get your education and, like, process all the information you're learning.
Mm-hmm.
Basically.
And then you want to find a group of friends. Having a group of friends that, you know, are like-minded, maybe they're in your major, or you live around them, they're your neighbors. Mm-hmm. Having those people around you as a support system while you're in college is very important.
Yeah, you want to make sure it's a good circle. Friends that just gonna, they just want to go all partying, they want to do all this drinking, they want to do all this other stuff that you're not supposed to do. When you know you got homework due at 11:59 that night.
Yeah, you should have friends that are pushing you.
Yeah, you need good friends. I promise you, y'all, college is where you should find your good friends at, honestly.
Yeah, honestly.
I found a couple good friends at college, in college. Mental health, y'all. Mental health is so important in college. I want you guys to really, like, just because you're in college don't mean, it's all about college, it's all about being fun and doing all these crazy stuff. But I feel like you should definitely take time to yourself sometimes and get your mind right. Because I feel like college, a lot of people go crazy in college. A lot of people go crazy. Like, people start dropping out because they just can't handle all the different things you do in college. Exactly. Like, it's just so many things. It's like you're in real life in college. Like, you're not in real life, but you're still in real life. Yeah. You know, it's like structured it gets real, basically. Yeah. It's like structured to be a school, but you got to live your own life by yourself.
Exactly.
So, yeah, I think that's it for me.
Last one I'd say is just managing your money. You know, there are a lot of parties that come up. It's just like, $20 here, $20 there. Mm-hmm. Adds up by the end of the semester. You done spent like $300 just to party.
I go to free parties now. I don't go to...
It's only free parties for me.
Only free parties for me, too.
If I got to pay for something...
Not paying.
It's just like...
It's not worth it.
Is it serious? Like, how lit is this party about to be?
Right, if it's
for
worth...
me to pay $20.
$20.
So,
don't do it.
Yeah, so manage your money. And that's pretty much all I got to say.
I like that one. But yeah, that's pretty much all I got to say too. So hope you guys enjoyed the video. Hope you enjoyed my guest.
Hey, follow me on Instagram at NRawiTrust and Twitter NRawiTrust. Peace.
All right. See you on my next video.